Hey guys, in this video we'll be going over Windows XP mode. If you have Windows 7 Ultimate, Enterprise, or Professional, you can go ahead and download this at Microsoft.com. I'll have this link in the description. Just go ahead and choose. I have Ultimate and we want English. And then you need to go ahead and download Windows XP mode and Windows Virtual PC. Once you've done that, go ahead and go to your start menu. If it doesn't, when you install both of those, if it doesn't show up down here, go ahead and go to Windows Features. So turn Windows Features off or on. And then scroll to the bottom and make sure Windows Virtual PC is checked. Then just click OK. And now you should be able to go to All Programs, Windows Virtual PC, and then Windows Virtual PC or XP mode. I'm just gonna go to Windows Virtual PC and then this should come up. And I'm just gonna go ahead and double click it just to start it. Might take a while the first time you start it up. Okay, now it's enabling its built-in features, and here you go. So I'm just going to go into full screen, if I can find it. Alright, view full screen, and here you go. You have Windows XP right here. Some of the features, oh, I can't get to it anymore, but yeah, so that's pretty much it. If you go and log off again. And then close it. Go and shut down. And in some of the settings, you can go ahead and change its name. how much memory you give it, some hard disks if you have any like external hard drives that you want it to recognize, networking, integrated features, and a bunch of other stuff. There's one more other thing that I want to show you. If you go into Windows XP mode and you go and drag and drop programs into the startup folder, under All Programs on Windows 7 and under Windows Virtual PC in mobile applications, you can go ahead and open programs from Virtual PC. Only the program, so you don't have to go into like boot into Windows XP. So this is pretty cool. Let me just show you this quick. I'm going to open up Microsoft Outlook Express. And it'll also load your little tray stuff down here. So if you have like Microsoft Security Essentials, like I do on Windows 7 and XP, another one should pop up once this is opened. So we'll just give it a second. Alright, there we go, it's finally opening. It shouldn't take too long for you, probably just because I'm running a screen capture right now. But as you can see, I have Outlook Express right here, and yeah, it's right in integrated into Windows 7. No like AeroSnap or anything that you can do. And you also have your little notifications down here, so you can see computer status protected. And it's showing you that it's the remote computer, which is Windows XP. And we also have Windows Live Messenger. So if you want to go and open that up too, you have it right there. And that's really about it. So please subscribe, everyone, and for more videos like this. And I'll see you guys in the next video.